Time for part two of our Carolina Live program from Classical Public Radio and South Carolina Public Radio. I'm Lauren Rico, and our focus is now on two very talented musicians who team up to bring you a concert titled The French Connection. You won't hear gunfire and screeching tires, as in the other French Connection, but rather wonderful clarinet playing by Matthew Hanna and very distinctive piano performances by a young musician who's been on Carolina Live a number of times, Christopher Tavernier. Matthew Hanna studied clarinet at Furman University and during that time was active in compositions. He entered the 1995 International Clarinet Association Young Artist Competition and won first place. He also placed first in the Southeastern Clarinet Workshop Competition, won the MTNA State and Divisional Woodwind Competitions, and was a finalist in the national level of competition. He's currently active in the South Carolina upstate music scene, performing regularly with local orchestras including the Spartanburg Philharmonic, Foothills Philharmonic, and Gamak Orchestra. He's also principal clarinet with the Brevard Philharmonic. He's a founding member of the Papageno Woodwind Quintet and performs as a singer and clarinetist on the front line of the Foothills Oompa Band. Christopher Tavernier made his orchestral debut with the Tar River Philharmonic Orchestra at age 13, performing Tchaikovsky's Piano Concerto No. 1 in the opening concert of the orchestra's fall 2013 season at the Dunn Center for the Performing Arts in Rocky Mount, North Carolina. Christopher began his piano studies at age 6 and has won several competitions, including the 2012 Appalachian Classical Music Association's Young Artist Competition in Johnson City, Tennessee. In 2014, he won the junior division of the Charlotte Symphony's Concerto Competition and the Concerto Competition of the Symphony Orchestra of Augusta, Georgia. Additionally, he placed second in the National Elizabeth Harper Vaughan Concerto Competition in Kingsport, Tennessee. He was the youngest performer in the history of the competition. Christopher's repertoire includes concertos by Bach, Mozart, Mendelssohn, Tchaikovsky, Rachmaninoff, and Prokofiev. He maintains a broad solo repertoire, including many works by his favorite composer, Franz Liszt. The performers begin with a sonata for clarinet and piano by Frenchman Francis Poulenc. The piece was composed in 1962 and is one of the last pieces Poulenc completed. It's dedicated to the memory of an old friend, the Swiss composer Arthur Honegger. It's given proper respect and a lovely performance by Matthew Hanna and Christopher Tavernier on Carolina Live. Thank you. Opening our sampling of music from the French Connection, that was the Sonata for Clarinet and Piano by Francis Poulenc. Matthew Hanna played clarinet, Christopher Tavernier piano. Here's another piece for the two instruments, Solo de Concours by André Messager. André Messager was a student of Gabriel Fauré and Camille Saint-Saëns, who wrote numerous operas, operettas, and ballets. He was later appointed commander of the Legion of Honor. He composed Solo de Concours in 1899 as a Paris Conservatory contest piece. Written in three sections, the cheerful first part contains triplet figures by the clarinet. The second part has a strong French melody, and the final section is notable for its rich melodic energy. Solo de Concours by André Messager.
Thank you.
That was Solo de Concord by Andre Messager with clarinetist Matthew Hanna and pianist Christopher Tavernier. Now the focus is on Tavernier alone as he plays two selections by Claude Debussy. First, you'll hear Reflet dans l'eau from Debussy's Images, six compositions in two series or sets, each consisting of three pieces for solo piano. These are distinct from Debussy's Images for orchestra. The pieces in the first series were written between 1901 and 1905, and the pieces in the second series were written in 1907. Then you'll hear L'Île Joyeuse, The Joyful Island, an extended solo piano piece composed in 1904. According to one commentator, the central relationship in the work is that between material based on the whole tone scale, the Lydian mode, and the diatonic scale, the Lydian mode functioning as an effective mediator between the other two. Two intriguing pieces by Debussy, played by Christopher Tavernier.
Thank you.
Claude Debussy's Reflets dans l'eau and Les Joyeuses, played by pianist Christopher Tavernier, part of a French Connection concert. He now rejoins clarinetist Matthew Hanna for another selection by Debussy, the premier rhapsody for clarinet and piano. It was composed between December 1909 and January 1910 and was dedicated to the French clarinet professor Prosper Mimart. In 1909, Gabriel Fauré, director of the Paris Conservatory, named Debussy to its board of directors, and one of Debussy's first duties was to supply two works for the next year's clarinet examinations. The Rhapsody was first performed as part of the examinations on July 14, 1910. The original composition was for clarinet and piano. Debussy published his own orchestration of the accompaniment in 1911. Here it is on Carolina Live.
Thank you.
That was Claude Debussy's Premier Rhapsody for Clarinet and Piano with clarinetist Matthew Hanna and pianist Christopher Tavernier. Christopher is featured now playing first a set of etudes by Frédéric Chopin, then a piece by his favorite composer Franz Liszt, the Grand Galop Chromatique. The French Connection is certainly a rich one in this concert.
Thank you.
Grand Galop Chromatique, and before that you heard pianist Christopher Tavernier play a set of etudes by Frédéric Chopin. To wrap up the music in a beautiful way, the final selection in a presentation that featured several great French composers, that was clarinetist Matthew Hanna and pianist Christopher Tavernier. The concert's title was The French Connection, and there's no doubt the two performers would have made their Gallic cohort smile. I hope our program had that same effect on you, and that you'll join us at the same time next week for more